Hey everyone, I did the book Shattered Dreams by Larry Crabb. It took me a while before I stopped saying Mr. Crabs, so this is try number like 4 or 5. But this book was a really hard read for me at times because it really hit home. It's a book with many highs and lows, like an emotional roller coaster. Questions answered and then more questions raised. It had stories with Naomi and Jesus. It was a great book for spiritual formation, to grow and understand suffering and pain and what to do with it. But the leadership portion was crucial. It had many stages, phases throughout the book, but the key ideas for writing this book for Crabb were: 1, that God wants to bless you. 2, the deepest pleasure we're capable of experiencing is a direct encounter with God. And 3, he uses the pain of shattered dreams to help us discover our desire for God. I'm going to focus more on 3 as we go through this. He uses the pain, and it sounds a lot like a self-help, not so much of a leadership book, but we're going to go through our lives and be approached by somebody someday that trusts us, someone who wants help and is lost, someone who just lost their hopes and dreams that they thought were the only way. The word shattered just sounds heartbreaking to me, and I'm glad he uses it. Why would a God allow some people to have joy, become healed, and not others? Crabb discusses that there is a principle that every person in the world can have available to them, whether they're rich, poor, sick, healthy, lonely, talented, broken, or hurt. No matter what the case is, and that principle is hope. When the darkest of nights come for us, when the people that we lead fall in a hole that is so deep that they can't get out of, when their shattered dreams come and hurt and pain takes over, a hope that transcends all of that. He puts bluntly, how do we trust God? There's more to that, but how do we trust God? And as leaders, we would want to help the people that come to us. But the mother who is suffering from Alzheimer's with no healing help, the addiction of the young Christian who is just trying to go through their day and it doesn't get better, the cancer that is painful to your grandfather continues to become more painful, the anxiety or depression that becomes worse. Why do some people get healed while others don't? Why give us a parking spot in the front of a random store on a random day, but not help any of our dreams? Good dreams that are not too over the top or too selfish or anything, but like a marriage that is rocky and you just want strength to get through it, but it ends in divorce and pain. I pray every morning to my unborn baby right now. It was a part of my spiritual practice that I don't want to stop. I hold my wife's tummy and pray for 10 minutes or so and just stay in awe at that moment and of the life that I want to give it. And if I were to lose that dream because it was God's will, I don't know if I could see the good in that. I honestly don't. That would be my ultimate shattered dream. I have been through a lot already. Some of you know, some of you don't, but I have a mentally and physically abusive father. He was addicted to alcohol, pills, porn, smoking, rape. And that's not a good father. My cousin that took care of me when my dad should have been died when I was young. And I thought I was at rock bottom. And then I almost died a few times and I thought I hit rock bottom again. And why would all that happen to me? In the big picture now I can see, but it still hurts. It still hurts. Seeing my wife crawl down the stairs weeping because anxiety and depression are consuming her and the pills aren't helping hurts. Not having the words to help or even comfort people I love hurts. Witnessing a grandmother lose her memory to Alzheimer's and deteriorate her body in pain hurts. Having our good dreams shatter, it's essential to know that this world is temporary. The pains and hurt will end and can never win because of the hope we have in the next life, heaven. When we see Jesus and God, there is no more pain or hurt. We'll know that real joy and not of earthly joy. This book has so much to offer to help people going through tough times and questions. And I hope you take the time to read it as much as it's helped me. Two things to finish on. Our podcast that I call Hinge, or that is called Hinge, that I listened to a long time ago. And there was a lady that came on the show and her words stuck with me forever. I'm going to look away because I wrote them down because I didn't want to mess them all up. But she said, I could force my child to live a completely safe life and never get hurt if I just put them in a completely padded room and shut the door, never to let her out, never to get in trouble, never to be afraid or do anything wrong. And as a parent, that is very tempting. But that isn't living. I could also be the only one in their life, but that isn't love. And this shows that being broken, hurt is part of this mortal life, that we can have hope in a perfect future someday. And if you have had any hardships or broken dreams, I hope that you have found this helpful or am glad that you still believe in God and have hope. It brings me joy. Hitting rock bottom or having those shattered dreams shows you real joy when everything is stripped away. I'm not saying that you have to have your dreams broken or your faith tested or trialed. You can still have very strong faith. If you haven't, I pray that you do and that you remain strong when it does happen. I'd call him a subordinate, but that's one of my soldiers that I am in charge of, approached me and asked why his sister that has gone through church her whole life with him was newly married and got married and was getting groceries and was raped and murdered on her way home. How do you look at someone who had faith and say that there was a higher purpose for it, that there was a part of God's plan? And he hit rock bottom and did not recover from it. He's still struggling, and he talks to me often. He's one of my best friends, but we talk about it. And lastly, the most impactful thing Crabb talks about for me is Jesus speaking to his disciples in Gethsemane. Jesus was their fearless, faithful leader, and he did what no leader our days usually would do, and broke down, crying. Now Jesus later then said, to not give in to temptation. And what he really is saying is don't lose hope. Then he promises them power, not to avoid trouble and hardships in this world, but the same power that was keeping him on course. The power to remain faithful no matter what happens in your life. In Gethsemane, he prayed that he did not want to die, but would. This shows us that suffering is important and God will not allow suffering unless to achieve his good purpose. An angel was sent to comfort him. I don't have exactly all the time in the world because I'm pretty sure I'm almost at 10 minutes and I should hurry up. But Crabb has the idea of what dialogue went between them and it pulled my heartstring. He thinks that it was Gabriel and it would be a great fitting to a great end. But because of whatever the angel said or did, Jesus eventually stopped crying. And to close, it's a longer passage, but I needed to hear it, and maybe you do too. So I want to read that. And it's about Jesus speaking words to us now. He says, some of your fondest dreams will shatter, and you will be tempted to lose hope. I will seem to you callous, or worse, weak, unresponsive to your pain. You will wonder if I cannot do anything, or simply will not. As you struggle with dashed hopes, you will fail. Just as my servant Peter did. You will feel discouraged with yourself to the point of self-hatred, and I will seem to withdraw from you and do nothing. When all this comes to pass, my word to you is this: do not lose hope. A plan is unfolding that you cannot clearly see, and if you could see as I do, you would still hurt. But you would not lose hope. You would gladly remain faithful to me in the middle of the worst suffering. I guarantee you the power to please me, not to have a good time, but pleasing me to bring you great joy. In the deepest part of your soul, you long more than anything else to be a part of my plan, to further my kingdom, to know me, to please me and enjoy me. I will satisfy that longing. You have the power to represent me well, no matter what happens in this life. That is the hope I give you in this world. Don't lose it.